Today's video on RMF security concepts, we're talking about POAMs. Some people say POA&M, some people say POAMs. POAM is an acronym for Plan of Action and Milestones. A lot of people don't really focus on the acronym that much, but what it is it an administrative task for security management that focuses on documenting vulnerabilities on a system, in an organization, in an application. It's just pretty much a way to keep track of issues, concerns, non-compliant items, anything that has to do with vulnerabilities that have been identified and needs to be tracked and corrected in a timely fashion. What does that mean? Let's say your organization has an issue. There's a piece of equipment, hardware or software, or there's some vulnerability that has been identified, right? Let's say there may be constraints, budget constraints, technical constraints, and or business process constraints that do not allow a quick rectification of the situation. There may be you have to go through the change board. There's a whole process you have to follow before you just make you start making changes to a system, correct? So let's say vulnerability A has been identified. It's a high vulnerability. It has a high impact. If it were to be exploited, it could mean, you know, bad things for the organization. So you plan that out in your POAM, right? You're basically saying, hey, we found this high vulnerability. We don't want to extend it out to a year, 6 months, 2 years, whatever. We want to rectify pretty quickly. So this is a way to administratively track your process on it. You could jot down dates and milestones. You can have a scheduled completion date. And again, it's just a way to track vulnerabilities and mitigate them and or correct them in a timely fashion. There are levels to POAMs, right? There could be a low POAM or low risk POAM. There could be moderate risk POAM. There could be high risk POAMs. They can be tracked either through paper, which is not preferred. They could be tracked through spreadsheets. They could be tracked through specialized software such as EMAS. There's always there's many ways you can track your POAMs. Each organization may have different ways of doing it, whatever works best for them. Speaking on RMF and DoD, we generally use EMAS. There are other solutions out there. I'm most familiar with EMAS. It's an application on the DoD servers that allows tracking of these things. And that's basically what a POAM is. Again, so just a really quick refresher, it's just administrative tasks on the security management side to track vulnerabilities, issues, concerns, things that may need to be corrected in an organization. And it can range from hardware to software to business processes to physical environment. There's a whole list of security controls that you could have different POAMs depending on your compliance or non-compliance on the control. If you have any other questions about POAMs specifically, go ahead and hit the comments. Granted, I have no real experience with private sector and how they deal with vulnerability tracking. I'm sure there may be similarities, but I'm focused more so on government, military, federal agency, DoD. That's what POAM means to me in that context. So I can respond to those. And again, please like, share, subscribe. I'm going to be doing more videos on RMF security concepts. Going to break down a whole new playlist. I appreciate you guys. I told you I was coming back. Here I am. Bunny Flocks, please check out the new website, cyberbunny.com. We are definitely going to get back on cybersecurity videos, trainings, tutorials, articles, and interviews. I'm going to bring back the interview with a hacker series, as well as interview with anybody, CISOs, security personnel, anybody within the industry, cybersecurity, mostly tech and other things. But pretty much I'm bringing this channel back. We're going to put life back into this channel. We're going to bring life back into the website. We are here. Thank you guys again for liking, sharing, and subscribing. I will see you guys on the other side. Please, if you can, share this video. And thank you. Thank you again. Appreciate you guys.